The last 9 years have been quite a wild ride for Cars24. It's gone from being a consumer-to-business auction platform for dealers to buy used cars to eventually becoming a full-blown consumer-to-consumer marketplace for used cars. And along the way, it's seen its fair share of highs and lows. Now, of late, once again, the business has been floundering. But Cars24 is dealing with it in the most characteristically Cars24 way, by undergoing yet another makeover. But this one may be its most intense one yet. Cars24 seems to be transforming into a full-blown fintech. It does help that the company is backed by some heavyweight investors, and with them backing it up, the startup is all set to launch a new brand, Loans24. You see, the startup got a non-bank license to finance used cars about half a decade ago. But back then, its financing arm was meant to be a lever to sell more cars. Now, it is so much more than that. It's digging deeper and really taking things to the next level. So with Loans24, it'll offer a whole gamut of financial products, including personal loans and loans secured against used cars. But here's the thing. Used car financing is complicated and very often messy. Generally, banks have had a concern about this space because buyers typically have a higher risk profile, meaning cases of default are pretty common. We'll get into why later on in this episode. But what you need to know now is that Cars24 is convinced it'll be able to manage the risks because of its deep understanding of the used car industry. Apart from becoming a one-stop player, amping up ancillary businesses like this one is how the company plans to drive up profits. So it's going all out. It's managed to strike up partnerships with some titans in the non-banking sector like Bajaj Finance. It also hopes it'll give it the edge that it needs in a pretty competitive market where it's up against the likes of Spinny and Roam. Not to mention automakers' used car divisions like Maruti Suzuki True Value and Mahindra First Choice Wheels. This is crucial because currently at a group level, Cars24 is neck deep in losses. The company believes that its non-bank arm will play a big role in turning things around. So far, its bet seems to be paying off because it has managed to make a neat profit of about 18 crore rupees for the 2024 fiscal. It may not be the biggest amount, but it could really help Cars24 with its ambitious mission to go public. It still has a long way to go. But this is a journey Cars24 is ready for, even at the cost of its core business, buying and selling used cars. Welcome to Daybreak, a business podcast from The Ken. I'm your host, Rahil Philippos, and I'll be joining Snigdha Sharma every week to bring you one business story that is worth understanding and worth your time. Today is Wednesday, the 7th of August. Back in 2019, there were a lot of big changes taking place at Cars24. It finally set up its financing arm. It started out as a platform for dealers who were struggling to secure loans due to their cash-heavy operations and lack of credit history. Simultaneously, its car marketplace was transitioning from C2B to C2C. It worked out well for the company because it meant it could cross-sell financing to its own customers. This is where the seed was sown. It was a huge opportunity for Cars24. It recognized a massive gray space in the used car loan segment. You see, if you wanted to get a loan to purchase a used car, in all likelihood, the bank you would approach would sanction a massive loan amount. That's because to determine the valuation of a used car, banks usually depend on a third-party evaluation report. And very often, they overvalue the used car. Banks are also usually hesitant to issue loans for used cars because of the high risk involved. Basically, banks believe that people who purchase a used car can't afford a new car, so their credit score will likely be of a lower grade. The assumption is that they will default on payments. Therefore, to mitigate the risk, they charge higher interest rates. Because in case of defaults, banks won't be able to recover the loss, even if they were to repossess the car. Now, this is where Cars24 sees an opportunity. A spokesperson of the company explained it to the Ken. They said that the company's expertise and deep understanding of car valuations and their depreciation over the loan tenure allows it to better assess the true value and risk of the collateral. So Cars24's average loan ticket is about 5 lakh rupees, with interest rates ranging from 10.5 to 19% depending on the customer's risk profile. To grow sales, the company was depending a lot more on its own financing unit. But that proved to be a can of worms that resulted in a hit to its loan books as well as to its partnerships. More on that in the next segment. When Cars24 was just setting up its non-bank business and finding its feet, it was able to strike up partnerships with several established players. So Bajaj Finance, Poonawalla FinCorp, ICICI Bank, and Piramal Finance. There was a fair bit of churn along the way, of course, but Bajaj and Poonawalla eventually proved to be their strongest partners, taking care of a majority of the lending. Eventually, over time, the business grew and Cars24 was able to start lending from its own books. That may not have been the best decision, however, because as more and more customers started defaulting on loan payments, the company started losing credibility with its lending partners. Customers would pay on time for about 5 to 6 months, and then they would start delaying or defaulting on payments. Executives said that to build its loan book, the business team was taking on more risk than necessary. So they were doing crazy things like giving 100% loan to value, meaning covering the entire cost of the vehicle, which is usually a deal only someone with a fantastic credit score looking to take a loan for a new car could swing. They were also increasing the loan tenure significantly, in some cases from 4 to 5 years to 6 to 7 years. In the process, its partnerships were getting affected. The company's system to allocate loan leads to different partners also didn't help matters. You see, Bajaj always had first pick. That's because the company had something called a co-lending model, where the income was shared and the liability was completely on Bajaj's books. With other partners, both income and risk were shared. That also meant that Bajaj invariably got the cream of the crop, while the loans that Cars24 took on its own books were of subprime quality. In the process, other partners like the Poonawallas, for instance, felt like they were getting the stepchild treatment. The tension resulted in Poonawalla and Cars24 eventually halting their partnership in used car financing over the past 6 months. Although Cars24 will still pass on personal loans to Poonawalla under the Loans24 project. Despite the hurdles, Cars24 charged on with its financing dreams. According to one executive, the company was approving 70 to 80% of the loan requests coming its way. A spokesperson of the company refused that claim, saying only 50% loans were approved. But that doesn't change how the company's loan book is faring. So it had to change strategies. Stay tuned. Since 2023, Cars24 has been in crisis mode trying to fix its loan books. It has changed the way it hands out loans significantly. Initially, its main metric was the share of used car buyers who were opting for financing for Cars24. But now, the risk team is being more discerning and taking on projects that will help it identify higher risk profiles. It then adjusts loan parameters for those customers. But while it was going all out with its financing business, its core business has taken a backseat. The signs of its struggling sales became visible in March 2023, when Cars24's sales had been stagnant at around 5,000 cars a month for the past 6 months. This is also why the company's appetite for risk has significantly come down. This, despite the fact that the used car segment really had its moment post-COVID. VCs were infusing a great deal of money at crazy valuations, trying to cash in on that wave. But the asset-heavy full-stack model and the lack of repeat business meant that the unit economics have proven difficult to turn around. So even after all that experimentation, Cars24 is still facing a tough fight both from organized players as well as the unorganized dealer market. The bottom line is, before getting ahead of itself in the non-bank space and in the marketplace, it needs to get its core business in order.
Daybreak is produced from the newsroom of The Ken, India's first subscriber-focused business news platform. What you're listening to is just a small sample of our subscriber-only offerings. A full subscription unlocks daily long-form feature stories, newsletters, and podcast extras. Head to theken.com and click on the red subscribe button on the top of the website. Today's episode was hosted by Rahil Philippos, produced by me, Snigdha Sharma, and edited by Rajiv Sien.